Hey all, hope you all are doing great. If you are watching this video, I think you know my name, as this is our fourth video. So for the newcomers, I am Atharv Tiwari, and today in this video we are going to talk about how you can set up your api.js file for authenticate tokens and to create meeting IDs. So for that, let's get started. Okay guys, so now we are on our screen. So in the previous video we have just set up our Node.js server, and in this video we will gonna create our API file and just customize our app.js file. So for that we have to go to our video SDK React App V1 folder. Inside this folder there is a folder named SRC, that means script folder. So in this particular folder we have to create our API file for creation of tokens and authenticate tokens and meeting IDs. So for that, just click on this create file, and the file will be api.js. Okay, so now our api.js file has been created. So in this api.js file, we will just paste some code. All the code are in description, so please go and check that. Okay, so here is the code. So this code is needed for our api.js file. So here you can see in this code, first let me explain you this code. This is the first, we are, as I have told you, we are using our localhost 9000. So this is for our localhost 9000. Then we will firstly declare a get token thing, and after that the token will call from our API with the method of get, and then token will be accepted and the token will be returned to the user or to the server for usage. With this we have just created a constant meeting ID, and this meeting ID similarly has been posted to the server for authentication, and then it will return the meeting ID to us. So this is the basic file for our API. So this file is, I'm using this for our api.js. after that, app.js. There are some things in app.js, but I have removed that, and we will just gonna paste our app.js file. For, as I have told you, in app.js, the main file for app.js, we will use that in our next video. This code is just for testing our API file, that is it working fine or not. So for just testing piece, I have written this piece of code. So this code, I have used this code for just testing part. So for now, let's run our server. So also remember one thing, to run both the servers, as we have to run our Node.js server. With this, we have to run our particular app. So to run the Node.js server, firstly we will go to our Node.js folder, then npm run, I have written sun, so run start, npm run start. So now our Node.js server is running on localhost 9000, and now we will just run our app. So for that we have to go to our React app folder, which is video SDK React app v1. Just hit enter, and then we will run our app. So to run our app, we will use a command npm run start React project, hit enter. Okay, so now our project has we have run our project, and it will just go to our Microsoft Edge. So let's wait till this run process completed, and automatically our window for our application will pop up with Microsoft Edge. So it may take some time as we are, our file is really big. So first also check that our localhost 9000 is running with the Node.js server, and after that firstly just run on the Node.js server, and after that run the React application. So it will be fine, and as we have to generate tokens with the help of this Node.js server only, so we are using Node.js for that. So it is running and running, it takes some, okay, so done. So So now our project has compiled, and now our screen will pop up, I think. Yeah, starting the deployment server. Our server has, that means our Node.js server is working fine, and now our screen has been shifted with localhost 3000, as our application runs on localhost 3000. And now, according to our app.js code, the meeting ID will show here. That means the our code in api.js is fine, that generate tokens and our meeting IDs. Okay, so here you can see our meeting ID is this. So you can also check with inspect element here. So the meeting ID is generating successfully. That means our app.js code is working fine. Also remember one thing, that in our app.js, in our app.js file, we will gonna change this file for our different for our output. So this is just testing code, so I will remove this code in the next part. And till then, stay tuned. For if you like this video, then just hit that like button below, and also subscribe our channel for more updates, and also hit that bell icon for our next upcoming videos. And thank you for watching this video.